And joining us now for our second hot copy, BARMM Chief Minister Ahod Ebrahim. Good morning, Chief Minister, and happy second anniversary to the BARMM.
Good morning, ma'am. Good morning, our viewers. And thank you for inviting me to this program.
Thanks for joining us today. 3 years on, or 2 years since ratification of the Bangsamoro Organic Law, you have completed the administrative code and the budget laws, the transition plans, and the Bangsamoro development plan. But there remains a few items in your to-do list as stipulated in the BOL. These are the revenue, electoral, civil service, and education laws, among others. What is your priority for this year?
Actually, first, we would like to complete the priority codes because now the status is administrative code is already passed in the parliament, approved by the parliament. Then in the committee level of the parliament is the three codes, electoral code, local government code, and civil service code. So we are hoping that within the first quarter of 2021, these codes will be passed. And then the two other codes are still under final discussion, final review of the cabinet, ministerial cabinet. So it will also be passed within within the first quarter of the year. So that is our priority. And the second priority is because of the COVID-19 pandemic, we have practically changed our focus in the government. And that is why many of our activities in the government, in the political aspect, were refocused to the to our addressing the challenges of the COVID-19. So now we are continuing. We are finishing our hiring of employees through our job portal. We have already hired about 70% new employees, and then there is still about 30% to be hired. So we will continue. The hiring was actually disrupted by the pandemic because we cannot do the processing, cannot do the interview, we cannot do the examination. So we have to postpone the processes of the hiring. So now we will continue. Yes.
Right. Chief Minister, correct me if I'm wrong, the hiring is for the bureaucracy, is that correct? And your yes. Priority had also been to pass the codes that are related to make sure that the Bangsamoro has a functioning bureaucracy, correct?
Yes, the administrative code is already in place, and then we have already the development plan in place. Our budget for 2021 is already passed in Congress. And so the different offices are already set up. So we just need about 30% of the hiring process for the bureaucracy.
30% of what number, Chief Minister?
We have lodged 4,000 jobs in the portal, and then now we have about we have already hired about 70%.
Correct. Okay.
So roughly about more than 100 is still not yet more than 200 is not yet hired.
Right. You mentioned the budget. Last year, you had some budget delays. This year, you have a budget of 68 billion pesos, including the Special Development Fund. Where will the bulk of the budget be spent? And what would be the impact if you encounter any budget delays further this year?
This year, we have already completed the deliberation of the budget. And the highest, still the highest budget was launched to education. Then next is on health, on medical and health services and facilities. And then social services also, and infrastructure projects, strategic infrastructures. All these are the main bulk of the budget is lodged in these issues.
Right, and you mark January 21st as a date of your commitment to pursue lasting peace and development in the homeland. President Duterte did pledge to continue support for social welfare, just as Bangsamoro Education Minister and Peace Panel Co-Chair Mohager Iqbal was saying that not enough services are going to the Bangsamoro people. Why is that so, do you think? And what would help in the delivery of services to the people? You did mention that education still has the highest allocation in your budget.
Actually, we still have remaining issues to be discussed in the IGRB. The IGRB is the mechanism wherein we discuss how the national agencies will be able to assist the Bangsamoro ministries in the delivery of the services. So we still have a lot of discussions to be made in the IGRB, but I think about 80% of the tasks of the IGRB were already almost completed, but we still need some 20 to 30% is still to be not subject for discussion.
What are those subjects for discussion, Chief Minister?
We still have I think let me sorry, yeah.
Oh, no worries.
The issues are still number one is black grant, the actual transfer of the black grant, because in the agreement the black grant is downloaded collectively and comprehensively. Pero ang nangyari, hindi pa rin ito supposed to be 1 year will be downloaded directly to BARMM Treasury. Pero hindi ho nangyari ang ganun. Naging monthly pa rin ang pag-release. So we are still discussing on this black grant and then the turnover of the national government agencies located in Cotabato City, then the BARMM inclusion in the national funded programs. Hindi pa rin kami nasali doon sa mga ibang nationally funded programs. Then Philippine Congress Bangsamoro Parliament Forum still on the process of discussion. Then the delineation of the Bangsamoro waters, hindi pa rin natapos. Creation of the Interagency Committee for Purposes of Inventory. Entry of MILF and MNLF members into the Philippine National Police. Special Development Fund ay hindi pa rin na-download. Creation of a Regional Coast Guard Office in the BARMM. Creation of BARMM office of the Bangsamoro, creation of BARMM office for the Bureau of Local Government funds, then Bangsamoro participation in national government, so transfer of management of existing natural reserves and project areas. So marami pa rin, mga 23 items itong na hindi pa natapos na discussion sa IGRB.
Understood. Now, you talked about the MILF earlier. Of course, checking out the Bangsamoro forum that we recently had in December. You mentioned the normalization track would be prioritized as well, and that a part of that 13,500 combatants have been decommissioned in the first phase, but 28,000 more combatants are due for decommissioning in the second and third phases, plus there's social transition. What about, apart from the decommissioning process, what about peace and security?
Well, as I have said, the decommissioning is, we have already decommissioned 13,500 of our 40,000 combatant to be decommissioned. Mm-hmm. And so far the agreed social and economic packages to be extended to them is not yet delivered to them. Mm-hmm. So we still have another 28,000. Now, on the security aspect, we are on the process of establishing a joint peace and security teams. This joint and peace and security team, we have started already the training. It is a combination of PNP personnel and AFP personnel and MILF combatants. So the not yet decommissioned. So initially we are targeting 3,000, 1,500 from the AFP and PNP, and 1,500 from our BF combatant. So this will be deployed as part of the security structure in the area. So ito yung then this will still be, but then we are also working the entry of our combatants to the PNP and the AFP. So that is still part of the discussion of the IGRB.
On the other aspect
we are continuing our dialogue for the other groups, yung mga small group na hindi pa pumapasok sa, hindi pa nag-join sa peace process, tulad ng BIFF, yung Abu Sayyaf. So on the BIFF side, meron na tayong mga progress, meron ng nag-signify that they will rejoin the MILF. So we are hoping success on the dialogue also.
That's such important work, definitely. You also mentioned the electoral participation. What's your assessment of the sense of inclusivity and electoral participation among BARMM constituents in the new parliamentary form of government 2 years on?
Actually, one challenge we are facing now is the electoral code is still under discussion in the parliament, hindi pa naipasa. And then secondly, yung mga combatant namin, meron sa kanila are facing warrant of arrest. Meron silang mga cases filed against them. So yun ang isang problema namin na we have to resolve all this first before an election will come, kasi hindi sila pwedeng sasali sa election if they have if their cases are not cleared. So isa yun sa kailangan na dahilan kung bakit gusto natin munang ma-postpone yung election for the parliament para itong normalization track will still be advanced para ma-ensure natin na when there is election, then the situation, the situation is already normal in the ground.
Right, Chief Minister, the Duterte government had agreed to that extension that you mentioned of the Bangsamoro Transition Authority for 3 years, or it seems like the cabinet had already. And is there any commitment from Congress on passing the bills related to the delaying of the regional elections to 2025 or even extending your powers to 2028?
As of now, there are five bills already filed in the lower house, the Congress. And we are still waiting for the bill, the counter bill that will be filed in the Senate. And we have talked to the different, we have already a dialogue with the different, many of the congressmen. From the speaker, the majority leader, minority leader, and leader then head of the committees. So we are assured of their support generally by both the speaker and all the major officers of the Congress. In the Senate also, we have talked to the Senate President himself, the majority floor leader, and some other senators also, although mostly are by Zoom. And they also assured us their support generally.
Did they indicate when those bills might be tackled? Is there a particular bill that you would prefer to be passed? And how much funding do you think the BARMM or Transition Authority might require if we extend it for another 3 years?
Now, I think the funding is still, there is no change on the funding because the funding is still the black grant. We will still continue to have the black grant. So wala naman dito ang pan. Extension of the period does not need any funding, any additional funding, because we already have the black grant that is regularly being downloaded to us.
Mm-hmm. Right, and a commitment on the when the bills might be passed?
There is also already a hearing of the five bills in Congress. The other day, they started the hearing, and although I was not able to attend in the hearing, but I represented my executive secretary and other members of the. But so the bills for the four bills, we are, it is acceptable to us because they are basically the same content, yung apat na bill. Only the one filed by Congressman Khalid Dimapuro, yung hindi kuan, kasi doon sa kanyang bill, he is still moved for the election in 2022. And then kung hindi daw matapos after 2022, yung normalization, saka extend ito into 2028. So sa amin, hindi ganun ang kuan. Hindi ganun ang kuan namin. Dahil there will be, pagka nag-election kami sa 2022, our focus will be redirected already to the election by starting October. So mawawala yung focus namin ngayon sa services to our people. So gusto natin na ma-continuous yung services namin and then implementation of the normalization na hindi na ma-affected ng election. Anyway, the local election will not be affected. Yung mga local government, they can go on. Only the parliament ang hinihingi namin na hindi muna mag-election, ma-move yung election by 2025. Right. So yun ang kuha namin. So yung four bills filed by Ismail Toto Mangudadato, Lauren Ligarda, and Majority Floor Leader Martin Romualdez, at saka yung kay Congressman Ungab of Davao City. So yung apat na yun ay acceptable na sa amin.
All right, lots of work that you've already done. I still wanted to ask you about the investment prospects for the BARMM, but unfortunately we don't have any more time, and still yes. Lots of work to be done, and we wish you well in those endeavors. BARMM Chief Minister Ahod Ebrahim, thank you so much for joining us today, and happy anniversary again.
Thank you very much, ma'am. Thank you.
Thank you, ma'am. Sir, and stay safe.